So right now we are mounting the sample, and I loosen and tighten it up so it's sturdy, and so when the x-ray runs, it's not moving around.
Big discoveries and big advances in science and medicine often start by looking at the smallest of items.
When I pull it up on the screen, I like to see the different, like how the different joints in the knee, the little things that we don't get to see from the naked eye that will show up on the computer. We can do 3D images of it.
Brittany Sloan is using an electron microscope to study the knee of a rat. She's looking for calcification in the joints. It's otherwise known as arthritis.
We want to kind of get this view right here. This is what we're looking for.
Researchers at North Carolina A&T are learning all they can about bones and joints because they are developing a new treatment plan for how to repair them. They want to create bioresorbable metal alloys, medical implants the body absorbs.
If you want to think about it in terms of when we were younger, they used to treat bone breaks with cast, right? And you want the cast to be there a certain amount of time, but over a certain amount of later, you can take off the cast and your bone's been healed. Well, this is kind of an internal treatment where you want this healing to occur, but once the healing occurs, then you want to sort of turn on the degradation properties and have it dissolve away.
Here's the idea. Right now, broken bones are often repaired by inserting a titanium rod into the bone, which holds the bone in place until it heals. Sometimes the implants are left in the body. Many times the implants are removed, and that poses the risk of another surgery. It's also expensive. Researchers hope this may change that. This is magnesium. It's a metal, but it's also an essential nutrient that the body needs and knows how to metabolize. The study proposes making implants out of magnesium, which is strong enough to support the healing, but over time would dissolve and be absorbed by the body. But there are plenty of questions that must be answered.
This is a specific alloy, so magnesium number 5.
Researchers need to know how well various magnesium alloys hold up in the body. A magnesium alloy is a combination of magnesium with another metal. Scientists need to test whether the alloy is strong enough to support healing, and how thick does the implant need to be. So, dozens of tiny magnesium plates will be placed in these test tubes that contain solutions that mimic the chemical conditions in the human body to find the answers.
From this 40 to 12, 8, 6, 5, even 4 millimeter, we are testing the mechanical property and also closing property of these. We found mechanically it's several times enhanced strength is. Yeah, for example,
the smaller you get, the stronger it is?
Usually, yes.
Okay.
There's also the question of just how the magnesium alloy implant would corrode. Would it last long enough to support the healing of the bone or the opening of an artery using a stent, much like this? These, too, could also be made of magnesium alloys. Chris Smith studies all of that at the microscopic level. Turns out, seeing the smallest detail gives you the biggest picture.
This is magnesium zinc calcium alloy. And so this is the microstructure within the alloy. And this is really important in terms of characterizing the alloy and gives you information on the mechanical strength, corrosion properties, things of that nature.
One floor up in the research center, you'll find these. The medical term is paper-based microfluidic device. It's an easy way for a patient to check on how well a broken bone is healing or the status of a magnesium alloy implant. It's all done through the chemical makeup of a patient's blood. A drop of blood is applied to the paper, and the reaction between the markers on the paper and the chemicals in the blood will indicate what is happening in the body.
What we can do is we take the blood and see how the marker is changed every day, every week, and then as an indicator, we can like predict the behaviors of the bone healing process in our body.
Part of the challenge for researchers in this building who are developing this medical technology is that each implant has to be custom made for a specific part of the body. So an implant that would be going into the jaw, say, would face different forces and even different chemical characteristics than one that's implanted in the shoulder or the heart or the hip or the knee.
Every time a screw or a plate, it needs certain property. It has to have certain strength when you pull it or push it. And its biodegradability, it's like corrosion. Then you're looking at when it dissolves, what happens to the cell around it. There is no toxicity. So you have to control all these things. So that means if you create a slew of alloys, what we call materials by design. So you've got a huge array of all kind of alloys. Then a doctor can select, oh, this alloy is good for a bone joint because this disappears in a different rate compared to hard stent into some kind of a screw goes. So different alloys for different things.
If this all sounds like medical science fiction, it's not. Researchers at North Carolina A&T are developing a wide range of magnesium alloys that would allow for customizable medical implants. If all goes well, your doctor could eventually select an implant that is tailor-made to fit your medical needs and even your body chemistry. The initial research on the idea began in 2008.
Now, alloys are being developed, all the properties are being checked, and we are looking at what we call a test bed. That means actually prototyping to check what if, does it work before you actually go on a human trial.
So this might not be a dream anymore. This is actually...
It's the dream becoming reality. It's a step by step. Mm-hmm. So we are working towards that.